My name is Hallie Sissom. I'm doing the executive briefing. My name is Hallie Sissom. This is the executive briefing for Management 604. I'm going to be talking about our current email group transition. So, 2 months ago, we created a group email, and departments were encouraged to use the group email. So our thought process was that this group email would provide three things. The first is that it would be easier to complete tasks when an employee was out sick or on vacation. If this occurs, usually the department would email that one employee. It could be a time-sensitive request, and this group email allows us to grab those requests and process them in a timely manner, even with that employee out sick. We would also be able to better gauge the workload of each of our team members by seeing all of our team's requests in one inbox space. This would also allow storage of email in all communications, which is really important if an employee leaves a team and we need to go back and figure out where something went wrong or what was communicated. Well, that's all in our shared inbox. So we're going to look at an overview of the project, this current status, and some of the challenges that we're facing. The goal of this project was to move away from departments emailing specific people and to create a space where all of our departments would put their requests into. The team manager is responsible for communicating this email change to the department managers. The department managers are responsible for communicating this email change to the faculty and staff members. The goal is to complete this project in 4 months. We have 21 departments, so we are bringing on board 2 departments per week into our group email. During this transition, it's the mission of the project to continue to provide excellent customer service. Where are we right now? Right now, we are in week 8 of this project. We have 16 of the 21 departments using our shared space. The department managers have so far reported 0 issues with the new email. Labels are being put on to each email coming into our group email inbox that describe who the request is for and what the nature of the request is. We're having weekly team meetings to assess how this transition is going and any issues that we're encountering. So to recap, the project is 8 weeks in. We have 76% of our departments using the shared email, and it's going very successfully. But there have been some challenges to this project. A few faculty continue to email individuals instead of using our group email. We are requesting that the individuals respond back to those emails with our group email instead of their individual email. We also encountered some issues with conversation mode. Conversation mode links emails with the same subject line, and when this was being done, it was losing requests within those lines of emails, and that we couldn't risk losing requests. So we had to take it out of conversation mode, which increased the number of emails in our inbox, which comes to our third challenge, is our inbox being over one page and not being able to be seen quickly as to what is still open. So to kind of fix that issue, we've created a pending folder where people can put requests into that pending folder, even if that request has not been completed. But as long as it is in process to be completed, it can go in there. Thus, we have one page, usually at all times, within our group email. So, to conclude, this has been a transition. It's still in transition, and we've hit a couple bumps, but we are proceeding at an expected conclusion deadline. We're going to hit that projected 2 months My name is Hallie Sissom. This is the executive briefing for Management 604. And I'm going to be talking today about our project of moving into a shared email. So 2 months ago, our team created a shared email space. And this is for all our departments sending us different types of requests to go into. We found that this shared space would have three benefits. The first benefit is that it would be easier to complete tasks when an employee is out sick or possibly on an extended vacation. If that email were to go to that individual and it was high priority, it would not be addressed, whereas when it comes into our shared email box, it can be addressed immediately. The second is that we will be able to better gauge each team member's workload. Sometimes one individual will get hit with a lot of requests in one day, and by seeing that come into our shared space, we're able to assign another team member to help that other individual out to get those requests completed on time. The third benefit is storage. This group email is a great spot to store all our communications. What if an employee were to leave our team completely? Well, we'd still have backup as to what they said, what they did, and why they did it in this shared space. So we're going to look at an overview of the project. We're going to look at the current status, and we're going to look at some of the challenges that we've been facing. So again, the goal of this project was to move away from departments emailing specific people and to get that one email space where all requests are sent. The team manager is responsible for communicating to our department managers exactly when they need to move their email requests to our group email. The department managers are then responsible for communicating that to the faculty and staff members. The goal of this project is that it will be completed in 4 months, and there are 21 departments that we need to transition into our shared email. We're going to be adding 2 departments every week. So during this project transition, it's the mission of this project to continue to provide excellent customer service. Where are we right now? We're in week 8 of this project. We have 16 of our 21 departments using our shared email. We have had 0 department managers come to us with issues with using the shared email. We are applying labels to every email that comes into our inbox. That label describes who that email is for and the nature of the request in that email. We're also having weekly team meetings with everyone using the shared email box within our team to try to address any issues that may come up while going through this transition. So to recap, the project now is 8 weeks in. We have 76% of our departments using this group email, and we think it's going very successfully. But there have been a few challenges that have come up while going through this transition. We have found that a few faculty have continued to send their requests to individuals instead of sending it to the group email. We encourage those individuals receiving the request to respond to them using the group email in order to enforce using that email address. We have also found that conversation mode has not been helpful when using a shared space. We have lost a few emails that get caught up in the string of emails, so we had to take it out of conversation mode. But by doing this, we created a very high number of emails in our inbox, which did not allow us to get a big overview of what was out there to be processed. In order to address this issue, we took a look at what could we do to create a pending folder. So we created a pending folder where people could take emails that have been started to be processed and put them in the pending folder and thus create less in our inbox, so we get a big picture of what is still out there to be worked on. So again, this project is on schedule to have all departments using it within that 4-month period. To conclude, the transition has hit a few bumps, but we are proceeding smoothly. The group email has received a lot of positive feedback from both team members who are getting those emails, as well as faculty sending the emails. The project is on track to be completed on time. Are there any questions?
Have you seen an increase in group collaboration after implementing the group email?
We have seen an increase in group collaboration. Just last week, there was an email that came into our group inbox that was labeled for, let's say, person A, but there was a person B who was still able to see those emails and read them, and they knew that they had information that person A did not. So A and B got together, had a quick meeting, had a knowledge transfer, and they were able to resolve that request very efficiently. So yes, thank you.